What's up, guys? Houndish here, and today we are jumping in with some very exciting Destiny 2 news, and we have the reveal for Season of the Worthy. So Bungie, jump in, we've got a new trailer. We get to see some of the juicy action that we're going to get for Season 10. Bungie talk about the new activities, we see new exotics, some pretty tasty looking new armor. And of course we get a roadmap, a breakdown of the Season Pass, and generally all of the content that we can expect to look forward to as part of Season 10. So in this video, guys, we're going to jump in, break down all of the new info, check out the new trailer, and generally take a look at what we now know about Season of the Worthy. So as always, I hope you guys enjoy the video, but without further delay, let's get into it. We should definitely start out by running the trailer in full right here. It's a pretty hype-packed one, so here we go.
Taken out the primary engine.
It's like they want this thing to drift off into space forever.
Not forever. Guardian, the Almighty is plummeting towards the last city, and we have no way to stop it. If it comes to it, we Guardians must be the ones to make a hard choice.
Still safe to say that Bungie know how to make one hell of a good trailer. Of course, in the opening scene, we see the Almighty right there. And also very exciting, we see some action with Zavala and Anna Bray in what appear to be some pretty awesome new cinematics for the DLC. And so it looks like we are definitely going to get kind of a leveled up story experience, really, on the most part. And following the Cabal's defeat in the Sundial, essentially the story here is that they've set the Almighty adrift, and basically they want to run it into the last city, and obviously that's going to cause us quite a few problems as Guardians. Definitely an interesting story concept right there. We see a character here with a very interesting looking helmet, just worth pointing out as we go through the trailer, but then we see Warmind bunkers, and from what Bungie say on the website, essentially, we're going to have to activate various different bunkers on different locations in order to arm Rasputin against this new threat. Definitely a cool concept right there. And there's a section of the trailer where we see this very bizarre kind of bot-looking enemy. There were actually concepts for a similar-looking thing back in the Warmind DLC, but it never made it into the game. And the enemy appears to be using kind of Warmind tech the same as the Javelins as some kind of weapon attack, which is pretty crazy. Very cool kind of enemy, or maybe not our enemy, right there. Obviously, it's part of Rasputin's arsenal. The next thing they show us are what appear to be a couple of new finishing moves. So we've got a Warlock with two kind of cleaver blades there. That's very cool. But then also a Titan. You've got this kind of Vex transmat sort of effect going on. A little bit like what you see with Divinity or something. But here they talk about new exotic quests and weapons. So we see a bunch of different weaponry. That does include a Tommy gun. Obviously pretty exciting stuff, but also Lord of Wolves is spotted. And there is going to be a new public event type activity that takes place on a few different locations, which is actually what we're seeing on the screen right here. Bungie give us more details from the webpage, which we'll break down in a moment. But that definitely looks very cool. And then, of course, we get lots of Trials hype. So a better look at a bunch of the different weapons and the armor pieces. And in the trailer itself, we hear some of Saint 14's dialogue, which is neat. And of course, some new emotes and stuff like that along the way. And so Season of the Worthy looks pretty hype. in terms of the story and what they've shown off in the trailer. But then, of course, we get further breakdown of what we can expect from the seasonal content on the season page. So we need to save the last city, and with the Sundial freed from the clutches of the Red Legion, one escaped Scion Flayer enacts a desperate ploy for revenge against the last city. Guardians of the Light must set aside old differences to band together with unlikely allies and save the city from total destruction. Definitely liking the story angle right here. But we're going to need to power up Rasputin. Time is running out, so it says race against time to save the last city. And new activities will include the Seraph Towers. Join your fellow Guardians and prepare Rasputin's defenses in shared public events. But then also bounties and bunkers. Rise to Rasputin's challenge and clear bunkers throughout the system to re-establish communication with the Warmind. So that definitely sounds pretty interesting. In terms of more gear, they once again show off trial stuff here. And the Cult of Osiris seeks Guardians with flawless execution and incomparable teamwork. Is the challenge of a perfect victory too daunting, or does your fireteam have the edge to reign? Exclusive rewards await those who never lose. So, bit of a tease to flawless rewards right there. And they say the pinnacle of PvP is back, and it's here to stay. Fight for victory every weekend in this power-enabled 3v3 Crucible playlist. All Guardians at power level 960 or greater can compete, and if you get multiple wins in a row, you can earn Pinnacle Gear and win 7 in a row to earn additional rewards and special access to the Lighthouse. So it is very much going to follow the classic Trials system, but you can also unlock a purchasable hat and pin to proudly celebrate your Trials victories everywhere you go, and so that's going to be a Bungie reward, potentially for multiple wins or a kind of quest completion, or maybe for flawless clears. But then getting back into some of the broader content, they show off some of the rewards. So we have Tommy's Matchbook. This is the new Tommy gun. And Tommy the Ghost presents us with a token of goodwill. Sure, it might just be a match, but all a Guardian needs to light up the darkness is a spark. And so a Tommy gun is definitely an interesting concept there, something a little bit different. But here they show off the Warmind Khanjali. I think I'm saying that correctly. But this is the artifact, so increase your power and unlock powerful seasonal mods each time you upgrade this sacred blade. Only you decide how much power is enough. So it's a better look at that artifact right there. Of course, we'll wait and see what some of the bonuses will be. But of course, the Season Pass will be a big one for players. And gear, XP, and rewards. Get the Season Pass and instantly unlock the new 7th Seraph armor sets and new exotic auto rifle, Tommy's Matchbook. You also get an XP boost that speeds up your seasonal ranks and exotic engram unlocks. And here we can see that seasonal armor, which is looking pretty cool actually. Definitely a bit different. And I guess we've generally got a bit of a Russian theme going on there. Let us know what you think about the armor down below. But of course, there is content that requires the season pass, and then some content that is free to all players. And as always, we get the free seasonal rewards and the paid season pass rewards. We get a bit of a preview right here. We can see the exotic auto rifle right there. Some of the legendary weapons, armor, an exotic ship reward, as well as a sparrow, and then ornaments, consumables, and things like that. Season pass owners will get access to weekly Rasputin challenges, legendary lost sectors, a new exotic questline, and instantly unlock the 7th Seraph armor sets for each class, as well as the auto rifle Tommy's Matchbook. And then we've got new triumphs, bounties, and seasonal lore books, an exotic emote, ghost, ornament, and finisher. And then all XP gains are increased throughout the season, with additional season pass rewards to unlock, and all free Destiny 2 content also included. And then for all players, you'll be able to defend the last city from the Red Legion by powering up Rasputin, play the new Seraph Tower public events and bunker activities, Trials of Osiris returns, and the minimum power level will be 960, but also, players will be able to upgrade the Warmind artifact to earn seasonal gear mods, and rank up to unlock the seasonal armor set, as well as ranking up to unlock the exotic machine gun. So that's definitely interesting, but we do have the roadmap right here. So on March 10th, we get the Seraph Tower event, and this is the new PvE activity, with new legendary weapons and armor. Of course then, on March 13th, we get Trials of Osiris for the first time, that's on the Friday, and this will return every weekend with a new seal and Trials-themed weapons and armor. And beginning on March 10th and March 24th, Seraph Bunkers on the EDZ and the Moon will become available, which are our legendary lost sectors. And so that's a look at the content that we get in March. But starting on April 21st, we get the Grandmaster Ordeal Nightfall. So this is a new Nightfall Strike difficulty, and this will also include a new seal, as well as endgame rewards. And then April 21st to May 11th will be the Guardian Games, which is a free event for all players, and it includes class competition and new legendary armor. That is a completely new concept, so maybe not getting the Revelry back or anything. And we can see the new artwork for that, but also we're getting this Seraph Bunker on Io on April 7th. And you can see that they put and more, and we do have fewer tabs on this actual roadmap. We also know that there's going to be an exotic quest, and so it looks like Bungie are kind of eluding these bits of information from the roadmap And there was a lot of conversation with the Bastion quest and stuff like that about whether Bungie should put those things on roadmaps or keep any of the secretive stuff more secret. And so it appears that that's probably what they're doing here, which is why maybe a few less beats are actually visible on that roadmap. But obviously without playing the content, I think what we've seen so far looks interesting. And so be sure to give us your thoughts about it down in the comment section, guys. Overall, I think it's a pretty good looking reveal. Definitely some really nice looking gear. So we'll have to get into the activities and the nitty gritty to get kind of a better sense of it. But once again, give us your thoughts on what they've showed from Season of the Worthy so far. Now though, as we move away from the reveal hype, we've got a couple of updates from Bungie about some of the changes coming in the March update, but also some stuff that is worth knowing when it comes to the end of Season of Dawn. So they said when Season of Dawn ends on the weekly reset on March 10th, some seasonal activities, triumphs, and gear acquisition sources will be retired in Destiny 2. And so for the briefest possible overview of this right here, of course, that will include content from the Season of Dawn Season Pass and bonuses from the Season Pass. Of course, there is the website where previously earned items from season passes can actually be claimed, so I'll link that down below. Currently, it is still possible to claim items from Season of Undying, of course, if you actually earned access to them in the season pass, so bear that in mind as well, because I'm not sure if that's going to change once we roll over into another season, but of course, it will also include the Season of Dawn seal and Savior title. And then incomplete items in the Season of Dawn Collections badge will turn invisible, emblems and shader quest items, and then the lore constellations, as well as the Lantern of Osiris seasonal artifact, and the power increase from the artifact. And then we do have other current season items like the bounties, polarized fractaline, time lost weapon bounties, the associated consumables, and then of course the Sundial Arena, the spire. Obelisks on destinations will disappear, the tower obelisk will vanish, and then quests from Osiris and Saint 14, as well as Saints bounties, are actually going to go away, but they do say that the Bastion quest will still be available, and then Devil's Ruin will be available again in a future season, so for the Devil's Ruin exotic quest, if you missed that, it isn't actually going to be available permanently. And so if you want to pick it up, get it done before the end of this season, or before the end of the week, pretty much. Otherwise, you may have to wait a few months, potentially. But of course, the Season of Dawn artifact mods will also go away, so it's worth bearing in mind that any of the mods from the obelisks are still going to work. And so if you've missed out on any of the obelisk mods that you can pick up and slot into seasonal armor, then it's definitely worth getting them now because they'll still be available to use in the game. But of course, the source to actually acquire them is going to go away. Bungie also list a bunch of different triumphs that are going to go away. So, of course, anything to do with Resonance rank, anything to do with the quests to repair the obelisks in the Tower Obelisk, of course triumphs to actually complete things inside of the game mode, and then separate things like the Season 9 Power Bonus, the Crucible Gambit, Vanguard, Nightfall, and pretty much all of the other challenges for this season, and their triumphs will no longer be obtainable, so bear that in mind. And if you want to see a full list of the stuff that's going to go away, then I'll also be sure to link that one down in the description box below. DMG did add that Dawning Gifts are also going to be removed in Season 10. You can currently still open them, so be sure to do that before they disappear. And then on the subject of the March update, of course, we know about a bunch of different changes, sandbox adjustments to weapons, abilities, and things like that, but Cosmo did add that Electrostatic Surge for the Warlocks should also be fixed in the March update, and it now correctly increases class ability regen whenever you're near allies. So that's a good one, definitely a bit of a letdown if you're using that subclass tree. But guys, for today, that's everything that we have to round up in this video. So let us know your thoughts about the reveal and all the new info that we've got about next season. Obviously pretty exciting stuff. If you're new to the channel, then be sure to hit subscribe and turn on notifications. That way I can keep you up to date with all of the news, guides, new content, and everything that you need to know about Destiny 2 moving forward. Also, if you've enjoyed the video, a rating very much helps me out down below. But for today, guys, thank you as always for tuning in, and whatever you get up to, I hope you have an awesome day.